Hello, my name is John Miller and I'm the owner of Enlighten Scientific. And welcome to this webinar on how to measure Zeta potential more confidently. The first thing that probably comes into your mind about making confident Zeta potential measurements are the good practices for making the measurement. So keeping the cuvette clean, using clean electrodes, filtering your diluent to remove dust and so on. But I want to talk about confidence in a broader context. That is, the context of making a business decision. After all, the reason that you're making a measurement is to support a decision of some sort. There's a process you go through, beginning with determining that you need to make the measurements. Then you make the measurements, interpret the results, and those results are used to make the business decision. Along the way, there are assumptions, and each of these assumptions needs to be met if you are to have the highest confidence in your overall interpretation and ultimately the decision taken. If you don't meet those assumptions, then your confidence level will decline. Which assumptions you need to meet, which are the more important assumptions, will depend upon the situation. It's going to depend on the product that you have. It's going to depend on why you are measuring the Zeta potential. Most of this isn't limited to the determination of Zeta potential. It applies to any measurement technique for any property that you need to determine. But a lot of instruments that you probably encounter are straightforward. There aren't many assumptions that you have to make in order to interpret the results correctly. Now, measuring Zeta potential is different. There are many assumptions to consider when interpreting the data. And that's what I want to share with you today. After this introduction, I'll give you a short bio of myself before getting into what I call three things that you need to know. These are three areas of knowledge that are important to understand: the science, the instrument, and the organization. I'll share some high-level considerations that you need to give to your strategy for measuring the Zeta potential for your particular need. The majority of this webinar will be about Zeta potential. I'll cover the origin of Zeta potential, some of the theoretical aspects, such as the calculation, how it's measured, and I'll explain where the assumptions lie that you must take into account in order to maximize the confidence that you'll have in your measurement. I'll share a real-world example of a formulation to illustrate the challenges that you might face. I'll review the content of the webinar, and then I'll go over some of the services that I provide that can help you, not just for Zeta potential measurement, but in the broader realm of colloid science and product development and manufacturing in general. Then we'll get into a question and answer session, which has no time limit. We can just keep going until there are no more questions to answer. And that'll bring us to the close of the webinar. So let me just give you a brief background to who I am and why I'm qualified to discuss this particular subject. I worked in the pharmaceutical industry for 24 years. I worked in early phase development. I spent a lot of time in late phase development, and I worked in the manufacturing organization. I was primarily involved with liquid dispersions and suspensions. So I have a lot of experience of decisions that need to be made for different types of liquid dispersions. I also invented phase analysis light scattering. And phase analysis light scattering is the method of choice for many Zeta potential measurements. All the leading electrophoretic light scattering instruments incorporate phase analysis light scattering. For some types of samples, it's the only way that these instruments can make meaningful measurements. So I understand the instrumentation. I've developed instrumentation for making very sensitive, accurate, and precise measurements of electrophoretic mobility and hence Zeta potential. I've seen how those instruments are used in industry. I've seen what it takes to make a confident business decision based on the data, and I've seen what it takes to make a wrong decision.